Hi, it's Peggy again, and I'm back. My video apparently was too long for YouTube, and I can't, for some reason, it's not working out for me. So I am going to try to restore it. I'm going to try to shorten it up and post it on YouTube, the third part of my canvas. So I thought I would just quickly show you real quick the finished canvas. Isn't this pretty? It's so cute. You know, I'm not too thrilled about my bird, but it's okay. You see all the flowers. Let me do it this way. Give you a little sneak peek. It's really pretty. I love stamping and then the glimmer misting over the top of that. So awesome. It was so much fun to create. And I added, there's got Prima flowers and all these little tiny ones right here. That's Prima. And then I mixed my Silk Store flowers in with it. And then I added buttons to the center, antique buttons. Or, yeah, some of them are antique, some of them not. Buttons. And it's really cute. So here it is, the finished canvas. And I'm actually already brainstorming. I think I'm going to do another one. Something a little different. But this one's kind of cute. So it's not bad for my first canvas, I don't think. I'm not an artist, but, or I don't have a degree in artistry, but I do consider myself an artist. So there it is. It's so cute. And this is all inspired by Marian Smith at apieceofcraft.com. And I watch her YouTube videos, and I watch her Ustream videos for Prima and stuff. I just love Marian. I think she's just so funny, and I just think she's so cool. She's like a really cool person. I think she'd be fun to scrapbook with and just have a play date with in a craft room. That'd be awesome. And so this is, you know, thank you, Marian, if you watched this video. Thank you so much for inspiring me to step outside my box and to create with what I have on hand. And I, like you, I can't throw anything away. Ask my coworkers. I do. I keep everything. I can't throw away anything. And that's probably why I have so much stuff in my craft room. All right. I'm going to show you also what I'm working on. And this is the Tim Holtz configuration box. And I also, too, again, I was inspired by Marian Smith to put old book pages on my configuration box, and I have these little bird nests and some little eggs I'm going to paint, and those are going to go in there. It's kind of going to be like a spring little box. So I painted it with turquoise, and it was too dark, so I mixed some of this in with the turquoise, and it still was too dark after I painted it, so then I did a white wash over the box, and then this morning it was just too white. I wanted it to be blue, so I took this color, Folk Art Sky color, and white. I did a wash of blue over it, and so you can see the white and the turquoise through it, and it turned out really cute, so I'm excited about that. And I'm not have great technical abilities, but I love doing videos. I think it's fun to watch people in their environment and do what they love to do. And I love to craft, I love to scrapbook, and I love to make cards, and I love altered art. So I've decided that this is a good goal for me in 2011 to, you know, start doing more just on the spur moment videos, and it's exciting. So, here again, I just wanted to show you one last glimpse of my finished canvas, and it was really fun. So, I encourage anyone out there to grab a canvas from this canvas store, or art store, and just start creating. It was really fun, and I can't wait to do more. So, I'm going to say goodbye, and have a great creative day. Thanks.